Madame la ministre, on a fait une discussion de...
Madam Minister, we have been talking now for 2 years in a very effective way. It was very fruitful and interesting. And our discussions were full not only of ideas, but commitment, real commitment, in particular from the perspective of businesses. And this afternoon, we discussed the link between governments and markets and the importance of Paris sending a clear signal. The floor is now yours, and once again, thank you for coming here this afternoon.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Kim. I'm going to be speaking French in order to be more specific in what I have to say to you. First of all, I've been following your debates because I have some colleagues who've been reporting on the very exciting things that you've said here. I was with Territory and Positive Energy, so to talk about meeting the challenge of 2 degrees C. So there's a link, a direct link between territories and companies, because we need you to apply the Paris Accord that we all want. Companies need to get moving, the territories need to get moving, citizens as well. So these are the three places that the decisions need to reach. And what is new, and the newest thing, the most positive thing in terms of the conference climate, well, we had Rio 23 years ago, so I've seen how things have evolved since then, and since Lima, Copenhagen, where I was present. What is very new is the commitment from companies, and I think that we have over the year between Lima and Paris, we've had a positive tipping point. For the first time, we've heard companies speak in the Business Week in Paris and then in the Business Week in New York as well, and they clearly talked about this issue of carbon pricing. France is moving quickly on this. There was a report that was submitted to the President of the Republic, and following that report, we decided to vote the energy transition law, which and we got a carbon pricing element introduced into that. And France has also taken the initiative to organize a coalition between countries on carbon pricing, because the meeting of heads of states and governments last Monday, there was a coalition of 40 different countries that have committed to this issue of carbon pricing. So I think that companies and the ones that are around this table, I imagine that you have allowed us to move forward very quickly on this, because we've come out of a historic period where everything that was good for companies by definition was considered as being bad for the environment, either because natural resources were overexploited and they were considered as being free of charge, or because pollution of the air, soil, and other things was all by companies was considered as being gratuitous. So there was a lack of confidence between the environment and the world of companies. And so I think that now we are moving into a new phase, a phase of reconciliation, without wanting to be too naive. When I got my ecology law voted, I think that we are moving towards a convergence between the issues, the problems of companies and investors, and protecting the environment, and the fact that we have the ability to really overcome this climate challenge. So it really is a historic positive period that we are entering, and where what's good for one is good for the other, and where companies are finally becoming aware, and some of you have done this a long time ago, but now we feel that there is a really a groundswell, if you like, which is beginning to understand that the cost of inaction is much higher than the cost of taking action. So companies really do need to get involved in their climate action. Secondly, the investments in climate sector and renewable energy, the circular economy as well, these are the sectors that are the most going to bring the most benefit and growth in the future. And thirdly, we are able to define rules which consist of making sure that we can evaluate these different actions and contribute to overcoming the world climate challenge. And I'm not naive. This doesn't involve all companies. There are a lot of companies, a lot of problems still in order to fight the over-exploitation of natural resources, amongst other things. But I do think that we are part of a positive historic movement. And the fact that we have a focus session like this in a climate summit, this is something which is quite historical. And we really do have to accelerate things, move forward more quickly. Now, a low-carbon economy, as you've all said, is an opportunity, and it's an opportunity which should not be missed. When I got my energy transition law voted, I lobbied for green growth. So the objective there of energy transition is creating wealth, creating value, creating jobs, and creating well-being, which in turn creates economic wealth. Now, to go talk about a low-carbon economy, it's absolutely vital to set a carbon price, as you have said, and I think that this is something which is very new, because it means basically that companies consider that access to fossil resources, which may be a short-term benefit, will become a cost in the long term. So it's not easy for companies to integrate the economic cost, the economic calculation over the long term. But this is what you're doing when you're asking for carbon pricing, because you have the ability to integrate this long-term prices and get economic gains. So imagine this long-term economic cost will be exponential. So we have to reduce that cost as soon as possible, integrate this into the microeconomic calculations and macroeconomic calculations, so integrate carbon pricing in those. Now, a couple of words on Europe. What's the situation in Europe at the time? Europe was a pioneer in terms of setting up its carbon market, but we are now facing difficulties. Companies working in Europe have experienced those difficulties. The carbon price is much too low in Europe. Since 2014, we launched a couple of initiatives and have taken several actions in order to increase the European price of carbon, such as backloading the market stability reserve. This is back on the European agenda, but not everything is solved. And let me explain, you already know this, but what are the different problems that we're facing? As a representative of a country that has set a carbon price in its law, 56 euros a ton by 2020, 100 by 2030, but in Europe it's around 8 or 9 euros. So what are the problems that we're currently facing then? First of all, at European level, the mid-term price on the European markets are much too low, and also this insufficient price will make coal-fired plants profitable up till 2013. So this is a sign that we have to take and clarify. And due to COP21, I think Europe will accelerate its action and will rectify its policies when it comes to carbon pricing. Then there's a lack of visibility, because we don't currently guarantee these means. Despite the tools that have been set up, we've got the ETS system. So there are some fluctuations then in, which don't allow the companies to have enough visibility. And finally, our European ETS system is based on a drop of 40% of carbon emissions, whereas this objective is a minimum objective. And I think that we could also even take things much further and use carbon pricing to reduce our emissions even further. And this is why we recently discussed with European ministers of the environment and energy on reforms that we could introduce in Europe for carbon pricing. For example, strengthening the CO2 quotas in Europe to establish a corridor for carbon pricing, which is sufficiently ambitious. And so a minimum price then for carbon. And then we need to extend carbon pricing to other sectors, because building, transport, currently are not involved in carbon pricing, and they need to be involved. And thirdly, we need to increase green investment. And finally, stop subsidizing fossil fuels. Once again, this decision, paradoxical decision that is being discussed at the summit, what's going to happen after fossil energy? So we see seen the massive subsidies given to fossil fuels. And so I really think that companies should also take up this cause and make it a taboo. Now, to finish with, I'd like to remind you of what we have done in France in terms of our energy transition law for green growth. I talked about carbon pricing. But for companies, in Article 173, it requires that companies publish in their annual reports that are approved by the board and the General Assembly of Shareholders. They have to produce an analysis of financial risks linked to climate change that they're exposed to, and also their low carbon strategy in order to reduce their GS emissions. So this is an obligation on in terms of direct emissions, but also emissions which are indirect. And I'd like to congratulate some French companies, Engie, amongst others, who have taken up this obligation, and the law will be applied from next year. And a number of French companies have already taken this objective on board then, just to show that this initiative is not necessarily a constraint. It's not punitive. It's something that is positive, and which the most dynamic companies, if they adopt this before other companies, they will have a competitive advantage. Now, in terms of institutional investors, in my energy transition law, I have provided. So this law asks institutional investors to measure their carbon footprint. This is a new obligation, and also to justify the means implemented to increase the green part of investment. And finally, I've created a label, a transition label for the climate, call for projects, which is based on two innovative principles. The first is the concept of the green part played by companies, and the second is the impact on the environment of their activities. This label, energetic ecology transition, requires a major investment in companies and in projects. And secondly, so, in environmental borrowing, so using impact indicators for climate change. And finally, some active management of any risks so for the environment and social risks as well. So I think that this is an experiment. We'll see how it pans out. But I think we can put all this together. And this label was co-built with companies and with the financial world. We worked with them so that we could really target this call for project, so that it produces a win-win situation for the climate and for companies. The idea is to identify investment funds that should finance the green economy. So secondly, we should encourage the creation of new green funds, and thirdly would be to facilitate reporting for companies on the green dimension of their activities. So once we get the call for projects, we will be able to redefine this, so we will be able to set up networks of companies, integrate the financial world so that we can improve this process, and also give account of this. So this is why this panel is so important, because I feel that it's by putting together and thinking together, using all our tools, that we will be able to accelerate economic transition and move toward. And so we want companies to be in the forefront of this creation of a better world.
Merci, Madame la Ministre, pour votre discours.
So thank you for that speech this afternoon. Thank you for the leadership that you have also shown in France.
This brings to the end our session. I would just like to recognize the absence, but you know, for reasons that are very legitimate, of our colleague Christiana Figueres, representing the third partner with the Global Compact, UNEP, and the Climate Change Secretariat in this Caring for Climate Coalition. She is like a laser beam focused on the negotiations, but let me end also by thanking again Lisa Kingo, the Executive Director of the Global Compact, and her team for arranging what is not an easy event to organize with so many participants. But above all, I would like to pay tribute to you who are here this afternoon, who have committed and who have shown leadership. Sometimes it's not the easiest thing to do. It's not the most profitable thing to do in the short term, but it's the right thing to do. And in doing the right thing, I hope others will follow, because as the Minister just said, anticipation is part of the reduction of the losers in our economy. And I think we've had 20 years notice that the low carbon economy is not only coming, it has begun, and business and financial markets need to align themselves with that reality. On behalf of the United Nations family, also thank you very much for your presence. Have a very successful COP and a good rest of the day. Thank you and goodbye.